Hello and welcome, my Scorpio minds. Today I'm gonna talk about pole, only about pole. I asked you on my Instagram if there's anything you want to know, and I got a ton of questions, so I'm gonna answer them today. And yeah, maybe you know I'm really obsessed with pole dance. I do it a lot and I just love it so much. And I actually signed up for my pole dance teacher training. It's gonna take place in 2 months, so I'm really excited about that and I really cannot wait. Alright, let's just get right ahead into it. First question, when did you start with pole? I started with pole around, it was like 2 years ago, something like that. And then let's get right ahead into the next question. What was the reason you started? The reason I start with pole, I already answered that in one of the last videos. I'm gonna link it here. It's because I was really into acro yoga, which is the partner acrobatics where you have the base, someone who's lying down, and someone like the flyer who's doing all the crazy stuff on top. And I was really into that. I think I did it for like 2 years also. But then the partner I was training with didn't train at the same place I was training anymore, so I kind of had to figure out and find a new partner. And then I went to open trainings and I trained with a different partner each time, which was fine, but you don't really get further because you kind of have to start from like the bottom all the time. And it just annoyed me a little bit because I really wanted to get better and it just didn't happen, so I stopped that. And pole dance had been on my mind for over a year already and I always wanted to try it, so I went for a training with a friend and it was just so awesome. I was so excited just to do it. There's also a question which said, was you nervous? Where did I write it down? It doesn't matter. Somebody asked, were you nervous for your first pole dance class? And no, I was not. Just because I have been working out and going to classes like already years prior, not pole dance, but just other classes. So I was just really excited and I was really looking forward to it and I was having fun. So no, I was not nervous. Just enjoyed the whole process a lot. Alright, how do you start if you have like no... or just if you want to start pole dance and you haven't done anything else, I would say just start, just look for classes around you. Just sign up for like the beginner class and then just go there. The teacher's gonna show you like how to start. They're gonna do a warm up. They're gonna do like a conditioning training just to build up the strength. They're gonna show you like the most basic trick. The first thing I learned was how to properly walk around the pole, because you kind of divide it into like quarters and you always walk on the straps of the quarter, so it's like a little axe and you walk on there, not just randomly, just to make it look pretty. So that was the first thing I learned and then we went from there. So really, do not be afraid, just go to a class and a teacher is gonna take care of the rest. And then also, how much strength in the upper body is required to start? Do you need to train that first? I mean, you can if you want to. It definitely helps if you're able to do a pull-up or just to hold yourself, because it does require a lot of strength, like biceps and shoulder and back and grip strength. But also, I wasn't as strong as I was now. It just builds up gradually over time, and the more you train, the stronger you get. And as I said before, the teacher is gonna do a warm-up and then conditioning, and in the conditioning there's usually some part of strength, or yeah, just like holding on to the pole, to whatever. So do not stress about whether you've done exercise before or if you've got enough strength. It really doesn't matter too much. I mean, if you have strength prior to starting pole, it's definitely gonna help and you're probably gonna see progress faster, but it's not a requirement at all. So if you just go to the basic class, you're just gonna start from zero with all the other people, so don't worry if you're gonna be the worst there or if you're gonna, I don't know, just go there. It's so much fun and everybody's having fun and nobody's judging you like, oh, she cannot do this, she cannot do that, blah blah blah. Everybody's like pretty much on the same level, and even for me, like, I still go to level 2 classes, which are kind of easy for me, but I love them because then I just get to work on the basic stuff to make them more pretty and to just get used to doing also the easy exercises more often. So, and I'm not judging the other people. I'm not being like, hey, you look stupid when you do the inversion or whatever. Like, I really don't care, and most or all the other students don't care. We're just focused on ourselves. And I, for my part, I love to help other people when they're struggling with something or if they have a question, and I'm just gonna help them, spot them, something like that. It really doesn't matter. Just go for it, have fun, and the rest will come. Could someone who didn't do ballet before or anything related to it start pole as an adult? This kind of comes close to the question I just answered. You don't have to have dance experience or acrobatic experience like I did. I mean, it helps if you know how to move your body and if you can listen to the rhythm of the music, if you know when you're upside down where left and right is and stuff like that, which is not always that easy. But you really don't have to. It'll just come over time. Like, you're gonna work on super basic stuff and then you gradually up that and you go from level 0 to level 1 to level 2, and it's just, you're gonna work on it and then you're gonna see how you improve and that you learn how to control your body and how to, I don't know, it's just like a mind-body connection that's gonna form over time. And of course, if you start it when you were a child, it's gonna be so much easier as an adult, but you can of course always learn that. Maybe it's gonna take a bit more time, but you know, it's fine. As long as you're having fun, it's totally fine. Do you think it would be hard to pole dance for someone whose hands sweat? Sweating is always a problem, and I do sweat a lot too. I sweat a lot, like on my arms, on my back kind of, and also on my butt and my legs, so it's also kind of a problem. But you can still do it, and there's stuff like dry hands or liquid chalk which you can put on your hands or the areas you sweat on, you need, and then you have more grip. So if you're suffering from sweaty parts of your body that you need from pole dance, you can definitely go for dry hands or liquid chalk, which is definitely gonna help. I use liquid chalk a lot just to get more grip, and when you do one trick it's fine, but if you do like a whole combination, then the sweat is just gonna go all over the pole and it's gonna be slippery and it's gonna be annoying. That's probably like the biggest part. But you can definitely do that. I have a girl in my training, she suffers from sweaty hands and she's really good, so don't worry about that. Just go for it and see how you go. Alright, what should I take with me to the classes? This is really easy because pole dance, you don't need a lot. If you go to a class, they have a pole, so you don't need to take a pole. You need workout clothes, and I always bring water and then either liquid chalk or dry hands and a towel, just because it gets sweaty and it's just nice to wipe yourself down sometimes, and also have the towel so that you don't sweat all over the mat when you warm up and stuff like that. So that's really not that much, right? Next one is, what clothes should I wear? Pole dance is a lot about using your skin with your pole, otherwise you're just gonna slide down. And there's another question I'm gonna answer it soon that's kind of about all of the being naked stuff. But first of all, like, when you just go to a class, you're probably not gonna do inversions or anything where you have to stick to the pole. It's more about using the hands. So it's alright to go just with workout shorts and a t-shirt. It's completely fine. I did that for, I think, the whole level 1 pretty much. And then once you start doing sitting on the pole or also inversions where you kind of need the skin on your upper thigh, and then also like here on your ribs and stuff like that, you should try and get pole clothes. Like, a sports bra is super fine, and then also those little bikini briefs. There are a lot of pole dance clothes out there, so just do your research. But yeah, you really don't wear a lot, which is kind of cool, but yeah. How often do you train? It kind of depends always. I would say between once and three times a week. I try to visit two classes a week because one class just is not enough for me. I only had one class last week. I don't know, and like I do it and I feel awesome, and then like 2 days later I could do it again, but then I don't have a class, and it's kind of a long stretch for like a week to get to the other class that I'm like kind of getting, how do you say that, I don't know, just that you feel that I have to go to the training again because I just love it so much and I want to move my body and I want to get better and create beautiful shapes on the pole. So I would say like 2 times a week because I have so much other things I do as well. How much time do you need to get as good as you are now? It's hard to say because I've been active all my life, and the video I just linked in the beginning is gonna show you all of the stuff I've been doing. But I've been practicing pole for around 2 years now. But yeah, it's hard to say. I already had the mind body connection, like how to move. I danced a lot, I did acrobatics, I had some strength, so I cannot speak for everyone, but just like training on the pole was 2 years now. And thank you that you think that I'm good. It's hard because sometimes you get caught up and you see other people being so much better and you think you're like, I don't know, like super basic, but then I, like if you tell me that you think I'm super good and stuff like that, it puts everything back into perspective and lets me see myself from the perspective of other people, and it really helps me to also think that I'm good and enough and stuff like that. But yeah, just thank you so much for your support. Another thing, how do you deal with blisters? I actually never get blisters from pole dance. I only get like cornea here on my hands and also here on my knuckles. This is also a bit from weightlifting, of course, but yeah. And I actually noticed this week, yeah, it was this week that I get cut sort of cornea. It's not really cornea, but it just gets rough around here because I have to grip the pole with my legs all the time. So yeah, it just gets rough there because it's a lot of friction, and then your skin just kind of gets used to it and builds up like a thicker layer of skin so that it doesn't hurt anymore, which is kind of cool because then it doesn't hurt anymore, but then also your skin is kind of rough. But yeah, it's alright, I don't really mind too much. Another question I got a couple of times was, how much does it cost? It's unfortunately not that cheap. I don't know the price, I think it was like 15 euros for one class, but it really depends on the studio and it depends on what kind of deal rate you get, like if you get a monthly subscription or like a yearly or just like a 10-fold class pass thingy. I am using Urban Sports here in Berlin because I just do pretty much everything with Urban Sports. It's a app where you subscribe and you have like a monthly subscription pretty much, and you can go to, I think right now it's around 900 studios in Berlin, like with everything, with swimming, with pole dance, regular dance, boulder, gym, just everything, and I use that pretty much every day. So I just pay 100 euros for that every month, and then I go to the gym, I go to swimming sometimes, I need to get back into swimming, I go to pole dance, I go to handstand class, so that really works for me, but maybe it doesn't work for you, so just see if there's something like that in your area, or just get a pole subscription, because then you can go as often as you want pretty much. Don't you get super dizzy when you're spinning around all the time? Well, at first, yes, it's really different and it's kind of weird, and sometimes you have shapes where you cannot fix a point where you have to look down at your legs or anything, and then I get really dizzy, but it gets so much better over time. The first time I tried spinning on the pole, because the pole can be spinning but it can also be static, and I practice both. but I prefer spinning because it's just prettier. And you can kind of do more more beautiful shapes, and it just looks more, for me, more amazing. But yeah, the feeling of getting dizzy is getting better over time. You just have to get used to it and do it over and over again, and start with just like a little spin, and then you can increase it and go like invert yourself, because if you're upside down it gets even worse and stuff. But I'm not that dizzy sometimes, depends on the move. Do people judge you when you say you do pole? Actually not that much. Most are super interested in it, and some are like, oh, what is it, like the sexy dance, do you strip and stuff like that. But it's not that often actually. Most people are educated about what pole is about. Some are really interested, and as I said, they just kind of want to know what it's about, what it's for, and then they explain that there are like so many different pole styles. You have the acrobatic ones, you have the stretchy flexible ones, you have the exotic ones, which is a bit more like showing off your body, which I don't like that much. I mean, it's nice if you like it, but for me I prefer the lyrical ones where you just dance a little bit, express yourself, just like modern dance, because I love dancing, and then I can also express the feeling of the song, or just, I don't know, make pretty shapes. I love it so much. But what I mentioned before is with the clothes also, I got a lot of judgment on Instagram when I first started pole, and when I first started wearing actual pole outfits, just like the bikini briefs and stuff like that. And they said that, like, how could I wear so little, and then other pole dancers are wearing like leggings and stuff like that. And but good thing is, I think either those people got used to it, or they just unfollowed me, so no, I don't get any hate anymore, which is awesome. Because you really can't not do pole with leggings. Well, they're special stick leggings, which you can wear, but I don't have those. But you really have to have the skin contact to the pole, otherwise it's just gonna slide down. I mean, you can try it and try to do pole dance with the leggings, but as soon as you do inversions and you have to have a grip, there's like no way, so you have to wear pretty much nothing. Do you use that grip liquid stuff every time you go to class? Not every time, but as soon as the... Oh, you're talking about like dry hands and liquid chalk. I use that when the combinations are getting more tricky and you're staying longer on the pole, because just if you're sweaty, it's just gonna get all over the pole, and then if you have to re-grip or climb up again, stuff like that, it just gets really slippery and you cannot hold yourself, which is really frustrating sometimes. Because when you just learn the trick by itself, it's fine, you can hold yourself, but then you do a combination with spinning and re-gripping and doing something else again, and I don't know, then it's really hard to hold the shape because it's just sliding down. So I'm going to a pole dance class today and I'm going to use the liquid chalk again. Also, when you're sweating a lot when in summer, it really saves my class. Can you teach pole yourself? So can you start learning pole dance by yourself? And I would say yes and no. I know that some people do it and it's good, but I think, or as for my experience, that you can definitely learn tricks yourself. You have tutorials online, you have apps where you can learn the tricks, but then you don't have a spotter, and sometimes a spotter is really helpful because then they can say like where you have to put your foot, where you have to put your hand, because sometimes it's really tricky to figure that out by yourself, because just when you're upside down and doing stuff, you think about how to stay on the pole rather than think about where your hands and limbs have to go, which is kind of weird sometimes, and you forget where left and right is, and you just forget what... sometimes there are tricks where you have to re-grip like 5 times or get from one shape into the other, and then you remember the first two, but then you don't remember the last two, and then it's really good to have a teacher around who talks you through the trick, just to do it once and then it's in your brain and you can do it yourself. So yes, you can teach pole yourself. You have to be a bit more careful, and I think I would be more afraid to do certain stuff just because I don't have someone around who spots me. But it's definitely possible. Maybe it's a slower process. And I also learned some tricks on my own here in my apartment, and then I went to class and we learned the same tricks, and I did them a little bit different than they are used to, so it's definitely nice to go to training once in a while. What is your main goal in pole dancing? I think I've got a couple goals. Like, for one, I love to stay fit, but I don't do it just because of the workout reason. I love to express myself, I love to learn new tricks, I love to improve myself, I love to just step out of my comfort zone and try pole dance tricks that are really complicated and what I'm afraid of sometimes, and I just see myself master it. But like, one of the super big goals would be to actually start performing and getting on stage and sharing my passion with other people. And I'm doing the pole dance trainer, so that's also one thing where I can teach other people how to pole dance and just share my passion with them as well, because I love it so much and I want other people to experience it as well. And also, by sharing it on Instagram, people get inspired, and I get some messages that they tried their first pole dance lesson and they were so happy, and it just makes me so happy to see that you guys are enjoying yourselves by something I enjoy so much too. So yeah, thank you for sharing everything with me. Does it hurt? Yes. Yes, it does. Because it's like it's a pull and it's hard, and sometimes you it's like a love-hate relationship. Sometimes I'm like, why do I do pull? Because it hurts. But it definitely starts hurting less the more you do it, and the more you do one trick, it's gonna hurt less for sure. At first, when I did sitting on the pole, so I just sit on the pole, was really, really painful, and I couldn't let go of my hands because it was like, ow, 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 it's burning the skin off of my upper thigh, and yeah, but right now it doesn't hurt anymore at all. You just get used to it. So I think you just have to get through the first pain. but yeah, it does hurt. And if you try a new trick, for example, right now, if I have to hold something with here, my triceps, biceps, inner arm, something, it really hurts still. So I need to do stuff like that more so that it doesn't hurt. And you get thicker skin everywhere. But it's, I don't know, for me it's so worth it and I love it. And I'm actually not that, how do you say it? Oh, I'm kind of pain resistant, so it's not too bad for me most of the time. Some tricks are just so painful. Do you get bruises? Yes. Not that many anymore, but when I first started, I just looked like I've been abused. Well, I'm being abused by my pole. But sometimes it really looked really bad, and I get bruises kind of easily, so yeah. But as with the pain, you get used to it. I don't get bruises anymore from like leg hangs, and I used to be super blue for that. Yeah, it's just something you should be aware of, that you get a lot of bruises, and maybe you have to explain it to some people. But it's also, for me, it's worth it. Alright, last question already. What thickness is your pole? My pole is 45 millimeter, which is, I think, the official, how do you say it, when you go competition size. They also have 40 millimeters, which is a bit thinner, but I find it kind of easier with the thicker pole because then you can hold on better. Some prefer the smaller size, so maybe just try it out in your pole studio. That were, I think, all the questions. If you have any other questions, let me know down below in the comments and I'm gonna answer them. Feel free to ask whatever you want, really. And other than that, thank you so much. I hope I answered the questions and that you you are more prone to go to a pole dance class now. I would love to hear your experience. So feel free to share them with me in the comments, on Instagram, via DM, or really whatever. So yeah, thank you so much. I am gonna get ready for my pole dance class now, and thank you so much for being here, for sticking with me, for supporting me, and just anything else. Lots of love to you guys, and have a beautiful week ahead.